Hey everyone, I'm Tiffany Jernigan, and we just released Tempo 2.9. So there's several things that we wanted to highlight in this video. There's more in the blog and release notes, but we added a new MCP server that lets AI assistants and LLMs, such as like Claude Code and Cursor, tap into your tracing data using TraceQL queries and other endpoints. So if you haven't heard of MCP, it stands for Model Context Protocol. It's an open source spec from Anthropic that standardizes how AI tools connect to APIs. So basically you can go and ask questions using natural language and get answers about what's happening, as well as investigate and diagnose issues more quickly. So like right now, if we were to go over to Tempo, so I am currently running just the Docker Compose local example. If you go to the GitHub for Tempo, you can kind of see at the top here, you can just run it locally. I'm just, again, using Docker Compose for that. If we go over here and we look at Explorer for Tempo, you could, for instance, go and click search and you can see, hey, these are all my different services. But say if you aren't familiar with going through this, or maybe you're not familiar with TraceQL and you're wanting to know that, then that's where our Tempo MCP server becomes really useful. So I'm going to be using Claude. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and add the MCP server. So if I do Claude MCP add. So right now we have Tempo running on port 3200. So if I run that, you can also look if I do a Docker PS, we can see right now, for instance, that it's a little hard to see here, but it's on 3200 there. And so if I just go and run Claude at the moment without all of that, it's going to go and ask me if I trust things. So then basically I can be like, hey, list all services in Tempo. We can just access it directly and it should go and end up telling us the same things that we were just seeing when we were looking at the front end for Explorer. So we can see we have the shop backend, our auth service, Postgres, et cetera. So we can see all of that there. So next, if we're like, okay, well, hey, how do I don't know that like TraceQL for trying to find an error. If you did know, for instance, you could just go here and be like, hey, status equals error. And then you can run your query. You can see the different ones that are having errors here. But if you didn't know that, you can go and actually just ask, like, find some traces with errors. So we can see that there's different like error patterns, some details about it. You can see that there's 20 traces with errors. Maybe next I'm just gonna be like, so find me some slow services. So then it tells you a few things and then you can just be like, okay, so why are these services slow? And then you can see that, hey, it's actually going, you can see that as a specific trace ID. It's going and looking into why that is specifically slow, where the time is being spent. Okay, so then we could, for instance, be like, okay, can you, like if we go back up here and we have like this trace ID, we can be like, hey, can you analyze this trace ID. And then I'll tell you more about that. So then you could also be like, okay, so what services have problems? And then if we just felt like it, we could be like, all right, so let's write a short poem about this. So we now have an ode to broken services. So yeah, basically just the types of things that you can ask via how you would just maybe go and ask a person, or when you're going and searching something online, you can use here for asking questions to learn more about what's happening with your traces. So another thing that we went and added is a new query hint that lets you speed up your queries by returning basically an approximate result using probabilistic sampling. Query hints are special options that you can add to a TraceQL query to modify how Tempo processes the request. So another feature that we added is sampling. So basically we added a new query hint that lets you speed up your queries by returning an approximate result using probabilistic sampling. So if you haven't heard of query hints, there are special options that you can use to add to a TraceQL query to modify how Tempo processes the request. There was one that we added in 2.8 if you want to go check that one out. So the first thing I'm going to do is just using TraceQL, I'm going to just get a rate of all of our spans. So we can just do rate. And then I'm going to go and run that query. So if we take a look at the query inspector after it runs, we can see that it takes a little over 3 seconds. So now let's try using our new query hint that basically adds dynamic sampling. So if we do with and then sample equals true, and then we run that, we can see that it takes less time. So basically the more data that you have, the more difference that you'll end up actually being able to see in the time that it takes between when you're running the original query versus when you're running it with sampling. So if we want to take a look at both of them, so if we just go and hide this, if we duplicate it and we get rid of that part there and we run it, we can see basically that the two graphs look super similar. There's a little bit of difference that you can see in some parts, but it basically gives you an approximate idea. So this can be especially useful if you have dashboards and you want it to run faster and be able to just kind of see what it looks like. If you want to be able to have more control over your query, then you can go and look at our release notes, since there are other query hints that we have as well. So please go and check out these new features, give us your opinions on them, and also the ones that we have in the blog and in the rest of the ones, the release notes as well. Also, please go to slack.grafana.com and join us in the community there. Thanks for watching.